The Green Bay defense is playing without three starters tonight. Defensive end Dayton Jones is out, as well as cornerback Sam Shields and safety Morgan Burnett. As for the Saints, they are without starting center Jonathan Goodwin. He'll be replaced by Tim Lolito, who's making his first career start at center. And running backs Kyrie Robinson and Pierre Thomas also sidelined with injuries tonight.
All right, thank you, Michelle. That means we're going to see a lot of Mark Ingram. Mike McCarthy took over in Green Bay in 2006, and Sean Payton took over in New Orleans in 2006, and each has won a Super Bowl. Thomas Morstead, who is their punter and kickoff man, will put it in the air. Green Bay won the toss. Packers have elected to receive. Kevin Dorsey and Harris, DeJuan Harris, are both back in the end zone. And so in New Orleans, where it's beautiful outside and perfect inside, we start with a touchback. And the Packers will start at the 20. Let's take a look at their starters.
Aaron Rodgers, Butte Community College.
Eddie Lacy, Alabama.
Jordy Nelson, Kansas State.
Randall Cobb, Kentucky.
Devontae Adams, Fresno State.
Drew Qualis, Penn State.
David Bakhtiari, Sarah High School.
Josh Sitton, Central Florida.
Corey Lindsley, The Ohio State.
TJ Lang, Birmingham Brother Rice.
Brian Belaga, Iowa.
Aaron Rodgers like to introduce himself from Butte Community College, where he started after high school and then went to the University of California. Drafted in the first round and sat behind Brett Favre for his first 3 years. And off we go on the first play of the game, a pass that's incomplete, intended for Devontae Adams, a rookie. Rodgers, in those last four games, that four-game winning streak, three or more touchdowns, no interceptions in each of the last four games, tied for the longest streak in the history of the league with Peyton Manning and Tom Brady. He keeps good company. Second and 10. And they give the ball to Lacy, who grew up here in New Orleans, and Lacy puts his head down and comes close to picking up the first down. Jordy Nelson helped to lead the way, and they will spot the ball on the 30 and move the chains. First down.
Josh Sitton barely got around there, but you know, you think of the Green Bay Packers and you think about Aaron Rodgers throwing the football, but this is a team with great balance right now too.
Rodgers flips one out to Cobb on the left side. Cobb runs into his own man, runs into Adams. Kenny Vaccaro making the tackle. Cobb, who was hurt for a good part of last season, he's been sensational thus far this year. Of course, when your quarterback is throwing that many touchdown passes, you are going to be the recipient of many of those, and in his particular case, eight. Second down and six from the 34-yard line. Lacy now runs into a bunch of traffic. No gain. Let's take a look at the New Orleans defense.
Cameron Jordan, UC Berkeley.
Akeem Hicks, University of Regina, Saskatchewan.
Roger Bonklin, Florida State.
Junior Gervais Gillette, Port au Prince Haven.
David Hawthorne, TCU.
Curtis Lofton, Oklahoma.
Keenan Lewis, West Bank.
Kenny Vaccaro, Texas.
Rafael Bush, SC State University.
Corey White, South University.
Pat Robinson, Florida State.
So the Packers come to the line. They kept their four receivers out and then huddled everybody else. And out of the shotgun on third down, with the play clock inside five now, and a flag is thrown.
Well, at Hockley. Offense, number 69. 5-yard penalty, it's third down.
The bulked up one calls it on David Bakhtiari, making it a third down and 10.
Well, Bakhtiari is just going to back out. I think that he heard the snap count, but I tell you, even the most veteran teams, when they come in here and this crowd gets rocking, and now they feel like they've already had an impact on the game, you're going to hear it even more.
Well, Green Bay should be used to it. They opened up the season on a Thursday night in Seattle. Rodgers dancing, has time. Protection is good, going deep downfield. And the catch is made by Randall Cobb. Cobb inside the 10, touchdown. 70 yards for Randall Cobb. The protection was so good. The coverage was initially extremely good. But Rodgers dancing around, and sooner or later, he'll kill you.
Well, they tried to bring a corner blitz here off the side, but only four guys came. So Aaron Rodgers recognizes that, knew he had plenty of time, knew they had the cornerback. picked up, and there he goes right down the middle. It's just a little out, a little up. Keenan Lewis really probably not his full responsibility, just never could find the ball. And there you go. Aaron Rodgers just continues at a torrid pace.
19 touchdowns to go with the one pick. That one interception was opening night at Seattle. 15 career TD passes, 70 or more, tying the record of his predecessor, Mason Crosby, for the point after. So we only played a couple of minutes, and just like that, it's 7-0 Packers. Sunday Night Football being brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Book your low fare now at southwest.com. By Farmers, get smarter at farmers.com. By Chili's, where fresh is happening now. And by Toyota, let's go places. Travis Trumpet Black and his followers on Frenchman Street here in the Big Easy.
It's not hard to find a party here.
Nope. Around the clock, 365 days a year, 366 in leap years. Mason Crosby sends this one into the end zone for a touchback. And let's take a look at the Saints starters.
Drew Brees, Purdue Boilermakers.
Mark Ingram, the University of Alabama.
Eric Lorig, Stanford.
Marcus Colston, Hofstra University.
Kenny Stills, University of Oklahoma.
Jimmy Graham, the U.
Teron Armstead, the Yard.
Ben Grubbs, Auburn University.
Tim Lolito, Grand Valley State.
Jairi Evans, Bloomsburg University.
Zach Streif, Northwestern.
For what it's worth, the Yard, Armstead School, is Arkansas Pine Bluff. Mark Ingram is the running back and the Heisman Trophy winner of a few years back at Alabama. Picks it up to the 24-yard line. Second down and six against the Packers. 381 passing yards per game. Those would be numbers for a minimum of five games. That's the highest in NFL history by one player against any opponent. And he would also be second in that category against Dallas. Equal opportunity. Second and six. Big hole. Through the middle goes Ingram to the 39. And they really need him tonight with Thomas and Robinson both on the shelf.
Come in with three tight ends over here, and Benjamin Watson on the inside going to get the good down block. And Ingram, who really is cherishing this opportunity. Of course, there are some guys that ordinarily get a lot of snaps, and Pierre Thomas and Kyrie Robinson not playing in this one. So this is Mark Ingram's night.
Going no huddle. And once again, Ingram will miss three games with a broken hand and then came back and had 10 carries last week in the disaster in Detroit, when they coughed up a lead in the fourth quarter and lost to the Lions.
Boy, I tell you, Ha-Ha Clinton Dix, the safety of the Green Bay Packers, is one tough guy, and he bounced right off of Ingram here. Good little Alabama on Alabama crime there, right? Just melted off of him.
Tied on tied. Second and eight from the 40-yard line. Tight formation, but five receivers go out, and the pass is caught by Travaris Cadet, who would be the guy who would be playing the role filled for years by Darren Sproles. They let him go, and he's now playing with the Philadelphia Eagles.
Yeah, he's their third down guy, and he's going to get a lot of action in here tonight. But you're right, we've been down here so many times before, and Darren Sproles and Jimmy Graham and Marcus Colston, kind of the big three here. And I think it's taken them a little bit of time to get adjusted to life without Darren Sproles.
You know, keep an eye, of course, on Graham, who's had that shoulder injury and was barely himself last week in the game against Detroit. Third down and three. Pressure on Breeze, but he steps up. He feels the pressure coming. Takes off and slides to a stop, picking up a first down at the Green Bay 49-yard line.
I think one of the young stars in the game is this guy right here, Teron Armstead. One of the most athletic tackles you ever see. Clay Matthews, he just shoves him inside. The stunt comes back around the outside, gets him as well, allows Drew Brees to step up and through, pick up a key first down.
Only the ninth rush of the season for Drew Brees. Now play action. And going deep downfield as a man open, a juggling catch. 3-yard line by Kenny Stills. Threaded it perfectly. Stills a bit of a juggle, but holds on. First and goal.
Mr. Big Play now for the New Orleans Saints. Had a big one for a touchdown last week, and Kenny Stills goes up and gets it. Great read on the coverage that time by Drew Brees. He knew the safety in the quarters coverage had to go away from that, leaving Stills one-on-one, and he goes up and makes the play.
46-yard gain. Devon House was covering him. Green Bay, as Michelle pointed out before the game, minus Sam Shields. So we'll see a lot of House tonight. We'll also see a lot of Brandon Cooks, who goes in for the touchdown. Their number one draft choice, a receiver, and he runs it into the end zone.
The old jet sweep. We saw Percy Harvin in the Super Bowl. Here it comes, and before you can figure out what happens, you got him in the end zone. Brandon Cooks, one of those guys that Sean Payton said, we just have to get him the football more often. I don't know how exactly, but I have to find a way. I feel like I'm slowing him down.
Six carries for him this season. He's averaging 12.8 per rush. Would have had a lot more there, but he only needed a couple to get into the end zone. Shane Graham for the point after. And so you've got Rodgers and you've got Breeze, and so far this one going according to Boyle, 7-7. Don't miss a moment of Sunday Night Football this season with NBC Sports Live Extra. Take the game with you anywhere, online and on tablet. Mercedes-Benz Superdome, 4 decades old. For Breeze and his backup McCown, going over the photos, and Aaron Rodgers ready to go to work again after Moore State's kickoff. It's the goalpost.
Go back to the Aaron Rodgers touchdown. Watch how calm he is in the pocket. Now, these are big guys coming after him, and he looks like he's sort of looking around for somebody in the mall. Where is he, Randall? Okay. Bingo. And then the flip side, Drew Brees, as always, just read that coverage perfectly. These guys are amazing in how they know what the coverage is. They just don't leave low-hanging fruit.
Change on the offensive line. T.J. Lang went back to the locker room. The pass is caught. 12-yard gain by Corliss as Lane Taylor takes his spot. Let's go to Michelle.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Lane Taylor in. T.J. Lang questionable with an ankle injury. When he came off the field, they didn't do much. Just put the ice right on it and took him back to the locker room. So not even testing it out, Al.
All right, thank you, Michelle. As you look at Lane Taylor, second year, free agent signee last year out of Oklahoma State. Thrown into the fire early tonight. And Lacey will get wrestled down, just hog-tied by Akeem Hicks.
Well, the first test for Lane Taylor, and go right around him. And Hicks is just going to beat him right to the inside and get through Corliss's block as well. That is some play.
Three-yard loss on the play, second down and 13. And Rodgers gets it away. Lacey makes the catch, has blocking across the 50. Eddie Lacey inside the 20 with a stiff arm, still on his feet. Look at that, to the 3-yard line. Got another 20, 25 yards out of it. As Everett looked like he'd be initially tackled, pushes Raphael Bush out of the way, gain of 67.
Well, you always have to be worried about the blitz coming against Rob Ryan's defense. But Al, this is going up and down the field so fast, we may need a racing form here tonight. This is crazy.
This is no claiming race either. His mom and dad, of course, he grew up here. Eddie Sr. and Wanda watching their man set up a first and goal at the 3-yard line. Take a look at this formation. Rodgers in a semi-pistol, and there's no gain here for Lacey Curtis Lofton. Having a great year for the Saints, leading tackler for them, pops him.
Yeah, a lot of times you get running backs that get a little break after a long play like that, but they tried to hustle to the line of scrimmage, and there's Mike McCarthy. I tell you what, one of the things that makes this game so exciting for me is I think you have two of the great play callers in all the game. Both head coaches can call brilliant games with brilliant quarterbacks. A lot of fun to watch.
There is Julius Peppers. They have him in the there. He breaks out of what would have been the tailback slot. There is Peppers set up wide to the left. The longtime linebacker going to throw it to him. He juggles it and it's incomplete. So he was anything but a decoy. As Peppers goes into the end zone as the target, it'll be third down and goal.
Well, it has to be about 6 inches of height difference, first of all. And you think anytime you put a big guy like that in, they're going to throw the jump ball in the back of the end zone. Instead, this former basketball player in college runs the slant and just probably a little too nervous for that one.
Pass a little behind. The Peppers has never had a catch. So Mike McCarthy going to the back of the playbook. Now they spread it. Play clock at 3 on a third and goal. And Rogers takes a look at the defense and says timeout.
Timeout Green Bay. That's their first. It's a 30-second timeout.
30-second timeout. It'll be third down and goal. Mike McCarthy getting the job in 2006. A bit of irony there. The Packers at that point also interviewed Sean Payton for the job. A lot of people thought that Payton had the slightly better pedigree at that point, would get the job, but it turned out to be McCarthy's. And, well, let's put it this way. Green Bay and New Orleans both made pretty terrific choices.
They did just fine. And Mike McCarthy was the offensive coordinator. Matter of fact, the first time he ever called plays was down here for the New Orleans Saints, and said the first one he ever called was fumbled. So it didn't get off to a great start, but it's gone darn well since.
That's Ted Thompson who made the call to bring in McCarthy. Third and goal, Eddie Lacy flanks Rogers in the backfield.
Vincent's got him in the
play clock at 1. They just do get it off, and Rogers is going to get spun down and sacked by Cameron Jordan. So they call the timeout, and the play clock gets set at 25, and they took it all the way down to 0.
Well, obviously just a mistake. They just don't block him, which is tough. I think that sometimes you end up with one of those quick passes called and your offensive line is sliding all one direction. If you don't get it off on the first look, sometimes you just don't get it off.
31-yard attempt now for Mason Crosby after a 10-yard sack on the third and goal, and Crosby gives them the lead. A little bit of a win by that Saint defense after that long game by Lacy. 6:08 to go in the quarter. 10-7. Back. Tomorrow and Tuesday, 7-time Grammy winner Taylor Swift joins The Voice. Can she turn these artists into superstars? The Voice tomorrow and Tuesday, 8 Eastern and Pacific, 7 Central and Mountain, right here on NBC. Bourbon Street Breakdancing, Halloween coming up. Everybody's in a costume around the whole here. And now you've got an onside kick attempt that's going to go out of bounds at the 47-yard line. So the 10-7, McCarthy has tried a pass to Peppers. And now an onside kick early on, a surprise onside kick, but the ball bounds out of bounds. And Ed Hockley will tell us that New Orleans will have it.
Touched the ball before it went out of bounds. New Orleans ball, first down.
And so a short field for Drew Brees when we come back. 3-point game. The two quarterbacks and some inside the numbers information on these guys. Brees at home here, regular season since 2011. 86 touchdown passes in 26 games. Better than 3 per game. 40 straight home games with a touchdown. Rodgers inside. He's played, this is game number 21, 47 touchdowns and 7 picks. Of course, he's pretty good outside, too.
I don't think it matters.
First and 10 after the attempted onside kick fails. And Brees, a quick drop and a quick slant to Brandon Cooks, who makes the catch at the 40-yard line. So Mike McCarthy going to the back of the playbook on offense and then going to it on special teams in the first quarter.
Well, and both these coaches, we were trying to guess before the game which one would pull something out soonest. And so McCarthy starts. They know that, what difference does it make? They're going up and down the field so fast. If you start from the 20, you start from the 40.
And Brees to the outside, incomplete. That was Colston who had position, couldn't hang on. Let's take a look at the Green Bay defense.
Josh Boyd, Mississippi State.
Latrell Guyon, Brefa High School Tornadoes.
Mike Daniels, Highland Regional High School.
Clay Matthews, USC.
A.J. Hawk, The Ohio State University.
Sam Barrington, The University of South Florida.
Julius Peppers, North Carolina.
Tremont Williams, La Tech.
Micah Hyde, The University of Iowa.
Glenn Dix, The University of Alabama.
Devon House, New Mexico State.
Minus two starters in the secondary, and Julius Peppers was their big offseason acquisition. Brees throws into traffic, and the catch is made by Kenny Stills for a first down. That time they had House covering, so it's a first and 10.
We told you how athletic Jaron Armstead is. Well, Clay Matthews maybe setting him up just a bit here, going with the bull rush straight at him. I watched Julius Peppers the play before. I think he might be still upset about dropping the touchdown pass, and he was on his toes as well, getting after Drew Brees.
Ingram back in at running back. And there he goes. Tries to keep those legs moving. Does a pretty good job of it, too, with about six white shirts. So Ingram is their number one draft choice in 2011. Actually, he's the second choice in the first round. They had a couple of picks. Won the Heisman Trophy at Alabama as a sophomore. And now here, he's been injured from time to time. He's had a share time with Pierre Thomas. Kyrie Robinson has come on, but with those two guys out, he's the horse tonight.
But, you know, the Saints have great rushing numbers, second only to Seattle coming into this game, just below 5 yards per carry.
Ingram again, and that's a first down. Mark Ingram to the 21-yard line.
Well, you've got Casey Hayward, who's the nickel guy in the game, and they're just going to try and run at that a little bit. As long as you're going to play your guys and take some linebackers out of the game, they're just going to turn around and be very content running the football.
Packer defense, only the Cleveland Browns allowing more rushing yards through week seven. So they're really good against the pass and not very good against the run. Saints have already rushed for 41 yards tonight on seven carries, and Brees slings one to the wide-open Colston, and he stays in bounds long enough to pick up the first down. Tackled by Micah Hyde.
Completely blown coverage here. Goes that way, and nobody goes with him. There is just nobody on that part of the field. Brees was pointing over at Julius Peppers on the left side, and they just somehow blew that coverage. Not exactly sure who it was, but there was nobody there.
Hey, kill, kill. Ball at the 11 kill, on a first kill. And 10. And over three to play in the quarter. And they hand it to the up back, the fullback, and this is Austin Johnson, who put a touchdown pass from Brees last week in Detroit for a gain of 2, second and 8.
It's kind of interesting, maybe the rarest of all things, Austin Johnson and Eric Lorig, two fullbacks active in this game. Austin Johnson, one of those guys, maybe not devastating as a blocker, but caught a touchdown pass last week, and they say he just does everything right, so his special teams couldn't take him out.
Short drop, pass to the outside, back shoulder incomplete. Jimmy Graham, it's the first time he's been targeted tonight, that bad shoulder and all. Micah Hyde with the coverage, third down and 8.
Well, he didn't catch any balls last week. He got the one-on-one coverage, and you can just write it down. If you're going to cover Jimmy Graham one-on-one, and you just wonder, could he reach out and catch that ball the way that he ordinarily could? Until he becomes a factor in a game, you have to worry about that shoulder if you're a Saints fan.
It's the right shoulder of Jimmy Graham that is the issue. Third and 8, and Brees continues to tug it at him and get him at the 13-yard line, and that's Julius Peppers. So Julius Peppers comes in, gets the sack. One of the few guys picked up Ted Thompson through the years. It's all about drafting homegrown guys, but he went on to get Peppers from Chicago.
One thing you don't want to do is embarrass a superstar player, and I'm sure after dropping that pass, he was thinking, it's time for me to go have an impact on the defensive side, and he goes right around Zach Streif, who's really been playing very well this year.
Shane Graham now a 31-yard field goal attempt. And that one will tie it up. 1:42 left in the opening quarter in the Dome. 10-10 in New Orleans. There was Mike McCarthy back in 2000. Chris talked about it before. The first play he ever calls as the offensive coordinator for the Saints in 2000, Jim Haslett is the head coach, is a fumble. Jeff Blake is trying to hand the ball off, charged with a fumble. Things got a little better after that, though, because that team wound up going to the playoffs and winning the Saints' first ever playoff game against the St. Louis Rams. And back to go for a Chris Collinsworth replay, ladies and gentlemen.
There you go. Well, Curtis Lofton here never gave up on this screen pass, and thank goodness he didn't, because it looked like Eddie Lacy was going to just drag Raphael Bush right into the end zone with him, but hustles all the way back down the field, and they never score from there, so that was a four-point hustle play.
Lofton, former Atlanta Falcon, came over here. Done an outstanding job as the quarterback of the defense. James Starch is now in at running back. Lacy will get a rest, at least at the beginning of the series. And here is Starch. Helped guide him to the Super Bowl about 4 years ago to the 21-yard line, stopped by Brandon Dedrick.
Now, one of the things that I was really wondering about tonight is what will we see from Rob Ryan against Aaron Rodgers in this great offense? And so far, he's following the plan that he used last week in Detroit. A lot more base, not as much blitz. We'll see how effective it will be. I think the Green Bay Packers would prefer that he blitzes.
Second and eight, and they do blitz here. They send five, and the catch is made over the middle by Adams, the good-looking rookie, to the 36-yard line. Devontae Adams started the last three games, drafted in the second round, played at Fresno State.
Well, you're going to get a matchup right here, and Marcus Ball is a young man that played in Canada. They asked their safeties to almost play like slot corners, and sometimes it's pretty tough when you're going against a wideout. That time, Marcus Ball unable to keep up.
Final minute of the quarter. Fake, and then the pass to Randall Cobb, and Cobb will get necktied at the 38-yard line, and that will draw a flag taken down around the neck. But the good, quick inside handoff, and who gets rid of the ball faster than Rodgers these days? Gain of 27. Hockley is the referee.
There for face mask on the play. First down.
Yeah, I didn't think they got anywhere close to the face mask, but watch the quick release here by Aaron Rodgers. The play fake and right up, and there's Randall Cobb, who's, now what a year that guy is having. Contract year for him. I'd like to be his agent. He is going to uncork the bank here.
200 straight passes thrown by Rodgers without an interception. Only interception came on opening night, the Thursday night opener on September 4th at Seattle. Play clock is at one, and Rodgers will take a timeout with 4 seconds to play in the quarter. 200 without a pick, second longest streak in Packers history. Bart Starr, and we want to send our very best to Bart, who's had some issues, of course, lately physically. 294 for the great Bart Starr.
How nice a man is Bart Starr. I mean, really, everybody, when we heard he wasn't feeling well, your heart immediately went out to their family, and just one of those legends that's probably even a nicer guy.
56 of 71, quarterbacking the team to their first two Lombardi wins. Well, they weren't known as the Lombardis at that point, because Lombardi was coaching them.
really personifies what this great organization is all about. He has been nothing but class as a player, as a coach, and now as a fan.
McCarthy had a question for Hockley about the timeout. Looked like they thought that the clock was going to run out before the play clock did. That wasn't the case. So now you've got the pass to the outside, and that is caught by Jordy Nelson, having a great year. Run out by Lewis, and that will take us to the end of the first quarter. It'll be second and two, and we come back. Green Bay 10, New Orleans 10, and Sunday Night Football continues after these messages. Aerial coverage tonight brought to you by Geico. As you look down into the city of New Orleans, that's the Crescent City Bridge spanning the Mississippi River here in the Delta. On a beautiful Sunday night outside, a lot of action inside, second and two. Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Michelle Tafoya. We start the second quarter. A spin around, then the pass is caught by Cobb. He breaks one tackle, not another, but he does get the first down, taking the ball to the 24-yard line. First down.
Well, they're turning this into just a one-on-one matchup on the outside with Randall Cobb, and these two guys think they're hot.
Well, look at Rodgers, 208 yards. It's the most passing yards in any quarter in his career. Doesn't even need the laces. Just spins around, throws it without the laces, and gets the first down. Rolling left. And a flag is thrown. He's out of bounds at the 22-yard line.
Offense, 59, 10-yard, repeat first.
That's the second one on Bakhtiari tonight.
Well, usually linemen think as long as they keep their hands inside, it's not going to get called. But if you see that sort of hook-like motion and the defensive linemen go down, that time working against the best of the pass rushers for the Saints, Junior Gallet coming in with four sacks on the season.
Now the graphic showing you that he's no stranger to flags being thrown. Left tackle, second year out of Colorado. He's had a false start and a hold. Stark sets up to the outside. Rodgers looks that way, fires over the middle, passes tipped and incomplete, intended for Randall Cobb. It'll be second down and 20.
You know, sometimes you wonder why these offenses do all the motion and do all that kind of stuff. Well, that time they sent James Starks, I think it was, out in motion, and the linebacker goes with him. So right now, Aaron Rodgers knows man coverage and exactly what he wants to do with the football.
Inside handoff to Starks. It's pounded down as he reaches the 31-yard line. And that will make it third down and 17. Hawthorne makes the tackle.
I just wonder what Rob Ryan's family's thinking right now. We have seen almost no blitzing at all thus far. And it's probably a good idea. The Packers were really hoping that they would come and end up in some one-on-one coverages, and they're just not giving it to them.
Third and 17, and they get Rodgers by the shirt, but he gets away, and then the pass is incomplete, intended for Starks. Cameron Jordan, who sacked Rodgers earlier, almost had him again, and then comes the field goal unit.
And just in case you're wondering, there is no horse collar foul in the pocket, so that is not a foul. But Aaron Rodgers, hard to corral, isn't he? Just has a way of stepping up and... As soon as he escapes, immediately gets his eyes back down the field again.
Here's Mason Crosby, made one from 31. This one will be 49 yards. Tim Maste with the hold. And Crosby's kick gives the Packers the lead. A couple of minutes into the second quarter in the Dome, 13-10 Green Bay. NFC South, and one break for New Orleans despite being 2-4. Look at that. Carolina 3-4-1, losing today. Seattle coming from behind in the fourth quarter. Saints could go to 3-4. Atlanta blew a 21-0 lead in London to Detroit, and then Tampa Bay lost in overtime. So if the Saints win, they'd be 3-4, and they go to Carolina to meet the Panthers on Thursday night in Charlotte. Touchback here. Well, the Saints putting up a lot of great numbers here. Touchdown streaks regular season. 136 straight games scoring a touchdown. The Browns over a 13-season span, 166. Chargers, Colts, and Saints now tied for third all-time in that category. Peyton came here in 06. Of course, he was suspended 2 years ago, so this would be his eighth season and scored a touchdown in all of his games. Now from the 20-yard line on first down, they hand the ball to Mark Ingram. Game four to the 24, tackled by Mike Daniels.
You know, some changes in the secondary for the Green Bay Packers this week. Sam Shields, who's been out a few weeks now, is probably the fastest player on the defense. He's got a knee injury. Devon House has taken his place, and Morgan Burnett, the starting safety, and now Micah Hyde and HaHa Clinton Dix, the rookie, man those spots on the back end.
Five wide on a second and six. Play clock at two. Trees fired and reaching out, making the catch at the 31-yard line as Kenny still knew he was going to get a pop. Had to reach out, extend the arms, makes the catch.
This is unbelievable. This catch comes up and just comes in with the slant. That thing was about an inch off the ground. That's beautiful. I tell you, when you know that Sam Barrington is sitting there staring you right in the face as a middle linebacker and about to take that shot, that is a tough catch to make.
And backhands it. Enough for a first down to the 31-yard line. England tries the left side this time. Gain of a couple. Dom Capers is the defensive coordinator. Sixth year as the defensive coordinator. There he is. The first coach ever for Carolina when they came in as an expansion team in 1995. It took them to a championship game, a conference championship game the next year. And he and Mike McCarthy working hand in glove, doing very well.
Spent a little time in New Orleans as well.
Mm-hmm.
You will see some exotic stuff out of Dom Capers. They play almost this entire lineup throughout the course of the season.
Second and eight, and Breeze throws, and the pass is incomplete. Crowd wants a flag, doesn't get it. One other thing about Capers, he was also the first coach in the history of the Houston Texans when they came in as an expansion team. There he is.
And his number one statistic is this, that he thinks that you can pick out who the final four are basically going to be if you take the differential between the opponents' quarterback rating and your quarterback rating. And right now, the Green Bay Packers are number one in the NFL, and that is the one stat that he says he does pay attention to.
Third down and eight. And Breeze throws, and that's caught. And that is Tavares Cadet picking up the first down. So on a third and eight, they bring in the third down back, and he moves the chains.
Well, one of the things you'll see out of the Packers is they bring sort of all their pass rushers in. They call this the NASCAR package. They love to rush five, and here it comes. And this is a really good sign if Tavares Cadet can step up in this game and be that third down receiver. Of course, Darren Sproles, all those years, that was his role. But this is one of those nights that Cadet's going to get a lot of looks.
Mike 50.
Bring a bunch of linebackers in and let them go. 45-yard line. And Breeze is going to go deep, and it's incomplete. Brandon Cooks had gotten a slight advantage but couldn't hang on. Tremont Williams back there with him.
Now this is a favorite play. They do that little half bootleg. Von House right there, stride for stride, but this is a perfectly thrown ball, and you just have to make that play. Aaron Cooks, the first-round draft pick, had a huge college career, and Drew Brees knows you don't get many like that.
House had the primary coverage, and Williams came over to help out from the safety spot, makes it second down and 10 from the 45-yard line. Breeze. And up in the air and bringing it back in is Cooks. Pretty amazing.
Looks like a volleyball tip. He goes straight up in the air, can't get his hands over the top, and it falls right in his belly. That's called a makeup catch. You go back to the huddle, you tell your quarterback, listen, that one's on me. Give me another try. He comes right back to the young receiver, and it pays off.
Gain of 14. Three tight ends here. Ingram goes through the middle, picks up 9.
Well, this Alabama connection is all one-sided right now. Mark Ingram is going to make Ha-Ha Clinton Dix miss again. That is his second time that he is just fanned. There he is, Ha-Ha Clinton Dix, and he is a physical guy. The only thing you wonder is sometimes does he go for too many big hits instead of just coming up and making a sure tackle.
Nicknamed by his grandmother, his given name is Haseem. They pick up a first down here as Cooks makes the catch and Williams makes the tackle. Saints with 11 first downs. Rodgers has led Green Bay to 7.
Ready.
Breeze 9 of 13 for 110. Pressure. And with contact made, he gets it to Colston. And Colston picks up 9. Yeah, Julius Peppers coming in. Almost had him wrapped up, and Breeze is able to get the pass away for a gain of 9 yards.
Well, the closer you get to the end zone, the more your pressure you're going to get. That time Casey Hayward came on the blitz off the edge.
Second and 1, and that'll be another first down as Mark Ingram takes the ball to the 18-yard line.
Put Sam Barrington in there, and he's a guy that they're going to try and get about 30 plays. He played 30 plays a week ago. They've been a little unsettled at that other linebacker position. Started with Brad Jones and then Jamari Lattimore. But Sam Barrington's one of those guys that can really strike. He and Ha-Ha Clinton Dix, they think, are going to give him an edge when the weather starts to turn later in the year.
This is the 12th play of this drive. And it's caught at the 10-yard line. Breeze hits Marcus Colston, setting up a 2nd and 2.
Great quarterbacks can stand in under pressure. Watch Drew Brees. He gets nothing on this throw. This is just a fadeaway jumper, all arm strength, and got it there.
Ingram back in. 6-minute drive at the moment. Started back at their own 20. Methodically going down the field. And now Ingram, he's going to get bottled up, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 1, hit there by Clay Matthews.
Well, Julius Peppers just shot right through there, unblocked. And really a pretty nice move by Ingram that time just to avoid the contact and a 5-yard loss.
Only their 2nd 3rd down on this drive. This will be the 14th play. Austin Johnson comes in at fullback. Ingram is the tailback. And then the pass is caught out in the flat by Stills. But Stills is out of bounds. So Stills came in motion to the inside, went back outside. Can't pick up the 1st down, and the drive bogs down.
Pretty creative call. They're going to come like it's going to be this jet sweep again, and then he's just going to loop back around and try and get him the football. But that was nicely done on the outside. I think that was House who came up late.
And for the moment, they're going to line up to go for it on a 4th down and 3.
Only because if they actually do this, of that guy right there.
I believe it when I see it. Just trying to draw him offside. So they take the timeout. And in all likelihood, they'll bring in the field goal group. And that appears to be the case here after the timeout. You know, it's a funny thing. You look at this game. I mean, New Orleans has won its last 11 regular season primetime games by an average of 21 points. Normally, they're heavy favorites, but tonight, just about even.
Yeah, I mean, anytime you get two quarterbacks going like this, you know it's going to end up being something special. But these defenses aren't too bad either. And so the gamesmanship that's been happening out here has really been a lot of fun to watch.
Yeah, you got two great quarterbacks. I mean, Rodgers having a spectacular year. I agree with you. You know, look, we all know about Peyton. Tom Brady, fabulous again today. But Rodgers right now, you're starting a team. He's your number one pick.
And in part because he's younger, too.
Right.
So, right.
Absolutely. 29-yard field goal attempt by Shane Graham is good. 5:52 remaining in the half. Locked up at 13. Next Sunday, Austin, Texas is the site. The Formula One United States Grand Prix on NBC. Lewis Hamilton, Nico Rosberg stake their claim to become the world champion. You'll see it next Sunday, 2:30 Eastern time, right here on NBC. Game tied at 13 with a little less than 6 minutes to go in the half. And Thomas Morstow will send this one deep into the end zone. And it will be down there by DeJuan Harris. So Rodgers back to Urkel, already throwing for 208 yards tonight. Look down Bourbon Street in the Big Easy. Pack started the year 1-2 on his radio show. Aaron Rodgers had to calm down the fans.
Five letters here just for everybody out there in Packerland and yourself today. R-E-L-A-X. Relax.
He's like the, as you look at his numbers since that time, he's like the Deepak Chopra of America's Dairyland. Let everybody calm down. Of course, he has helped to calm him down with a fantastic performance and starts this drive with a 15-yard gain and a first down against the rookie Devontae Adams, tackled by Lofton.
Boy, that's a good sign for the Green Bay Packers and Aaron Rodgers right there. They have been looking for that third threat, Devontae Adams. Aaron Rodgers keeps telling him in practice, you have to show me in practice, let me trust you in practice, and I'll start throwing it in the games.
Lacy. I listen to Rodgers, and I get relaxed.
A little hypnotic. I think he hypnotized some of the defenses he's been playing since then. You know, since he made that comment, he has thrown at least three touchdown passes in every game. I mean, that's pretty amazing.
Well, he has a way of when things don't look very good. He told us 2 years ago, we had the game in Houston, and they're going crazy in Green Bay. They're not playing well. And he says, hey, look. He said, outside, the sky is falling. Inside, we're just fine. And they went on a long winning streak. Second and eight. Rodgers. All the way to the New Orleans 40 as he guns it to Rodgers, the tight end. Richard Rodgers, rookie tight end out of California. First down.
Watch the feet of Aaron Rodgers. They seem to just hover above the ground. They never really get set. He just very calmly goes from one side of the field to the other, and if you give him enough time, he will take some sacks. Now, that is part of the deal, but you give him enough time, and believe me, he's going to find it, and he won't miss it.
Rodgers, third-round draft choice. 319! That was a gain of 22. Off play action, then he goes back to Lacy. Lacy gets a block. Lacy has a first down, a gain of 13 yards. Raphael Bush makes the stop. Lacy's a kid who grew up here. The family was displaced by Katrina and went to Baton Rouge. Rock came back, just bought his mother a house. But what he'll have to do, they have a bye week coming up next week. He has to fly back with the team tonight, and then he's going to come back tomorrow to take a look at the house he bought for his mom.
He's never seen it. He bought his mom a house, displaced, and comes right back, and it's really a wonderful story.
Lacy again. And Lacy for a gain of 9 behind a Josh Sitton block. Lacy, of course, had that 67-yard reception. Right now, 6 carries, 19 yards.
Just watch the patience here. He knows he's fine. They're just going to sort of like Aaron Rodgers, I guess, in the pocket. And there's Josh sitting out in front, waiting for the big guy to get going.
No huddle, second and one. Flag is thrown. Could have been too many men on the field here. Jordy Nelson was the intended receiver. And Hockley will make the call momentarily. So they tried to rush it on a second and one.
Defense. It's a 5-yard repeat second down.
So he did what he set out to do. Catch him, trap him with an extra man.
One of the hard parts about trying to substitute down on one end of the field or the other, which is typically when teams, especially defenses, want to substitute, it's a long way to go. And by the time you start running somebody on, the quarterback sees it. More often than not, you get trapped.
3:07 to the half. Rodgers. And flag is thrown here. That was White covering Devontae Adams. They're going to call it a catch.
I think that's going to be offensive.
It could be. Adams, the rookie, may have pushed. It is. Got to get in a new microphone.
Yeah, that's got to be killing him.
Yeah, no kidding.
Devontae Adams going up the field. And watch this little push right at the tail end of it. Arms extended. Pretty easy call from the official about 3 feet away.
That's a funny one. You're right.
Like making him wear a long sleeve shirt.
Like, oh, yeah, that's the worst thing of all. Be first down and 20 at the 23-yard line. Both head coaches call in their own plays. Play clock down to 3. And Rodgers clapping, but it's going to be a delay of game here.
Delay of game, okay.
They got the rookie center, Corey Lindsley, who's done a pretty good job this year, all things considered, but that time maybe the noise got to him.
Well, Corey Lindsley's first game was in Seattle. And this place is probably about the same number of decibels. He said, come on, Corey. Of course, Corey played at Ohio State, so he played in the big house in Michigan. This isn't all that stunning to him.
Now, first and 25. He'll dump off to Lacy. And Lacy, some tough running, gets spun down to the 43-yard line. That's going to take us to the 2-minute warning and make it second down and 20 with 120 seconds. And let's see the
New Orleans.
It is trying to say, I think maybe did the Saints try to call the timeout here?
Just call it.
Well, I think Sean Payton's saying there should be 2:06 on the clock.
It's a 30-second timeout.
They did get the timeout. So with a second and 21, he's already looking ahead, obviously, to the other side of the two-minute warning. Use the timeout here, gets a free timeout of the two-minute warning. They'll get the ball back one way or another. Let's say he's assuming they're going to kick a field goal, and then they'll have one timeout left.
You know, one of the things that we thought, Al, was going to be the great matchup in this one was Keenan Lewis, the best cover guy for the New Orleans Saints, going against Jordy Nelson. But at least thus far, it has really been almost more zone. You always see the blitz out of New Orleans and Rob Ryan's defense, but they are changing up and staying with the philosophy. They played their best game probably a week ago defensively against Detroit. And maybe because this defense is so young and they've lost so many of their leaders on the defensive side that maybe they're just doing a reset. And so far it's been working.
Now Nelson's their leading receiver with 47 catches, but only one so far tonight. They're trying to reset the clock to 2:07. So the Saints got the timeout. Payton trying to conserve as much time as he can on the other side of the two-minute warning. Again, the clock obviously stopping at 2 minutes. And then it would be third down, assuming they don't get into the end zone. Second down and 20.
You see the two deep safeties. That's the look they've been in most of the night.
Four-man rush. Over the middle, low throw, and it is incomplete. Jordy Nelson went down, hit the ground. Vaccaro comes up with it. Now it's third and 20. So even better for the Saints right now to save even more time, because now you're going to still get the clock stopping at 2 minutes and they won't have to use a timeout.
Well, sometimes the receiver gets his hands under the ball, but I do think that one hit the ground first. Good job by Ed Hockley and these officials.
Third and 20, and Rodgers sends it over the middle, caught hard line by Richard Rodgers, the tight end. That's the 2 minute warning, which comes with 1:56. Green Bay will attempt a field goal, and the Saints will have a lot of time on the other side. 13 all at the Superdome. So it's fourth and six. Field goal unit comes in. Rodgers back on the bench. And Mason Crosby, who's made from 31 and 49, will now try a 27-yarder. And the kick is right down the middle to give Green Bay the lead again. 1:51 to play in the half. 16-13, Green Bay. Sunday Night Football being brought to you by Subway Restaurant. Subway, train hard, eat fresh. By Chevrolet, find new roads. By Disney's Big Hero 6 in 3D, November the 7th. And by Bud Light, stay in the game, drink responsibly. Outside the Superdome, and their fourth annual Gleason Pep Rally here on Friday night. Steve Gleason, the former Saint, joined by current players, including Drew Brees, to raise awareness for ALS. And there is Steve at the game tonight in New Orleans.
Well, I tell you, that is one night you will never forget, though, when they returned from Hurricane Katrina for the first time, and that guy right there, Steve Gleason, blocked that punt, and this place went crazy. There's the statue forever memorializing that great moment.
And so much, of course, that happened in 06, 05 was the devastating hurricane, and I mean, team is small potatoes compared to what happened here, but it did help emotionally the city to climb back as Cadet makes the catch and takes the ball up to the 27-yard line. Of course, Breeze has been so much a part of what's been going on here over the past decade.
You almost get the feeling he might be running for something someday, don't you?
He could.
Well, he'd be good.
Second down and three from the 27. Ton of time over the middle, wide open 45-yard line. The rookie Cooks. And he'll hustle up to the line of scrimmage with 1:20, clock ticking down. Saints have one timeout.
All the credit goes to the offensive line there. That was a very deep route, plenty of time to do it, and Breeze, nobody around him, made the play.
Again, nice clean pocket, but then he has to dump it off to the outside. And that stops the clock with 1:03. It'll be second down and 10.
Well, here's that NASCAR package again with all their best pass rushers in the game. And so far tonight, it's kind of looked like go-karts out there. They have not gotten close to Drew Brees. He just finally had to throw it away because there was nobody open.
Covered wagon.
Yeah.
63 seconds, second down and 10. From the 45-yard line. Play clock inside five. And again, they dump it off screen. Cadet. And Cadet will finally get written down by House at the 39-yard line. They want to conserve that timeout. Hustle up to the line of scrimmage. Gain of 16 yards.
Boy, it just has to be what a relief seeing Cadet play like Darren Sproles has for so long.
Brees flushed out, look out from behind, and down he goes. Clay Matthews, now a timeout taken by Brees. And for Matthews, has put a lot of pressure on quarterbacks this year. Only his second and a half sack back in the field. So at halftime, Roethlisberger, fabulous day, 6 touchdowns. We'll see him next week on Sunday night against Baltimore. Gronkowski had 3 TDs. The Patriots dominate Chicago. Bob Costas will weigh in on the prolific quarterback play this week. Roethlisberger, Manning, Brady. Here's Breeze throwing, caught on the run to the 24-yard line. Marcus Colson, again, they're out of timeouts. Clock down to 22 and rolling. Ball to 24. And he's got Stills lining up to the other side. Breeze throwing. The flag is down. Colston. And now you've got Casey Hayward coming up with the ball. We'll get the call here. The clock stopped with 4 seconds. Boy, they're living right on the edge with that.
Illegal contact, defense, number 33. It's a 5-yard penalty from the previous spot and an automatic first down.
So Micah Hyde on that one, and Sean Richardson, the other backup safety, was beaten on the play before. So now Breeze starting to work on some of these backups in the Packers secondary.
Now they got to attempt a field goal. Hey, they're fortunate the catch wasn't made. You know, in the middle of the field, they couldn't have spiked the ball and would have had no time at all.
Penalty would have saved them, of course, on that one.
Right, ball at the 27, so a 37-yard attempt here by Graham. And the penalty was big because it stops the clock and enables the game to get tied at 16. So two early touchdowns and then a bunch of field goals. And the game ties 16 each. Coming up next to the halftime after these messages from your local NBC station. 16-16 at the half. Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Michelle DeFoya in New Orleans. Rodgers and Breeze, quarterback comparison there. Rodgers over 200 yards in the first quarter alone, 278 at the half. Breeze at 187. Meanwhile, Nelson, their leading receiver for the Packers, only one reception. And Graham with that shoulder injury, no receptions. And Green Bay so proficient this season in the red zone, they've been there twice, but have had to settle for a pair of field goals. So each team was able to score on its first drive, get a touchdown, and then each with 3 field goals since. 16 apiece. Cadet is back to receive, and New Orleans will get the ball as we start the third quarter with a touchback.
Well, Jimmy Graham, no catches last week in Detroit, and no catches so far in this one. Let's take a look. You can see it's that right shoulder, and he really doesn't move it very much. He came up a little sore after that one, landing hard on the shoulder. Now watch his right arm. He just is kind of dragging that. He admitted to us he was pretty much just a decoy a week ago, but now here he is in the middle of a big game for the Saints team. He knows he has to play, but he's only been in about every third play or so.
And he knows he has to play on Thursday night at Carolina in a big game. Flag comes in. Mark Ingram, the ball carrier. Ed Hockley, the referee. For the new Mike, we hope.
Holding offense, number 66. 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Much better. Michelle.
Well, Sean Payton stressed patience on both sides of the ball. He likes the way his defense is playing in the red zone, and he says he'll continue to show Aaron Rodgers a variety of looks on defense. Meanwhile, Mike McCarthy most concerned about his defense, particularly the running defense on first down. He says we've got to keep the Saints offense off the field. Their guard, by the way, TJ Lang, out with an ankle injury.
All right, thank you, Michelle. He went out early, and the pass is caught, and they put Graham into the game, and Jimmy makes his first grab here, run out by Sam Barrington.
And best of all worlds, he didn't go to the ground. You can see he's going to fight hard at the end of this little out route here to not go down, but just to get the ball back in his hands. I know as a receiver sometimes, you know, you don't even feel like you're in the game until you have your first catch. So a lot of coaches will try to just feed the ball to their star players early just so they get in the flow of the game. And certainly going to help Jimmy Graham there.
Back to the bench now. That was a first and 20, gain of 11, so it's second down and 9. To the ground. Nice hole over the left side and a first down and more for Ingram. Tough running all the way to midfield. Mike Daniels has to run down there and chase him down after a huge gain on a second and long of 28 yards.
Ingram is making everybody miss. Devon House is going to come up here and have him dead to rights in the hole and barely gets a hand on him. This has been a fantastic performance thus far by Mark Ingram, and Traveris Cadet's played well also.
Ingram 11 carries, 76 yards. Breeze a little screen to the left, and a lot of traffic is there, so Mark Ingram gets bumped down in a hurry after a gain of just a couple by A.J. Hawk.
Perfect time to do the screen pass. They came with a slot blitz off the edge, and they threw the screen right in behind it. Thought that one might have gone for even more yardage there, but good hustle by the Packers defensively.
Second down and seven. Two tight ends and Cadet in the backfield here on this set. Breeze, four-man rush, throws, and that's caught. Jimmy Graham getting the action here and very close to a first down.
Yeah, and one of the things that Jimmy Graham can do for you, a little injury timeout here, is draw that defense in, and then all of a sudden they start coming in because they're worried about Jimmy Graham. Now some of those outside guys can make some big plays for you.
So they'll measure. It'll either be a first down or a third and a couple of inches.
Jimmy Graham's got a lot of nice things going on. He's a pilot, and he's getting ready to start this Angel Flight program where at the end of the season he's going to take kids in need of medical care and fly them personally to the hospital they need. And he's a guy that understands what giving back is all about.
Beautiful.
Tough. He had a tough upbringing, didn't he? It just so many different things. Becky, a lady that sort of took him in when he was at his greatest need, now lives in Texas. She's a nurse practitioner and obviously takes great pride in what Jimmy has become with his life. Like, he is certainly giving back now.
Like so many great tight ends now, Antonio Gates and Julius Thomas. Tony Gonzalez, of course, will be another off the basketball court to football. Now, a little problem on the handoff to Austin Johnson as the two collide. They give it to the fullback, only needed a couple of inches, but he gets stopped in his tracks, and so it's going to be fourth down.
A little trouble with LaTroy Guyon, I think it was, in there as well. This pressure right up the gut. They barely got the handoff, and then Guyon got penetration, and now I do think they go for it here.
So you get fourth and two after a loss of almost 2 full yards. It was third and inches, so fourth and two. They will go for it, and they hand the ball off to Ingram, and he is going to get stacked up. And that will give the Green Bay Packers the ball at their own 42-yard line on their first drive of the second half. 16-all in the Superdome.
Jordy Nelson with 11 touchdowns in his career of 50 or more yards. The big play threat for this Green Bay Packers offense. And Keenan Lewis, the guy in charge of shutting him down. A lot of zones in this matchup tonight, but there have been a few man coverage situations. But at least so far, it has been much more of Randall Cobb working inside. And maybe they're just avoiding Keenan Lewis because they know he is the best. And the Saints have had some issues on the other side at the cornerback position.
Packers stop them. That was the first drive of the game that did not result in points. Lacy. And Lacy gets taken down. He can't get to the outside. Raphael Bush, the safety, knocks him down at the line of scrimmage. Second and 10.
I don't think I'll ever forget watching Eddie Lacy play in the national championship game against Notre Dame. My son is on that team. And it was remarkable to see a guy that size with spin moves. And he was just, you couldn't tackle him that night. And what a remarkable performance. And he said, that's the first night I ever really felt like I was a little something different.
Second and 10, sliding to the left and then hitting Cobb for a big gain. And a first down. Aaron Rodgers with a little slide step and right on the money. And Aaron Rodgers now has thrown for 298 yards tonight. Gain of 20 here.
Here comes the best pass rusher around the corner, Junior Gillette. Unable to get there. Aaron Rodgers just drifts that way. It has been Randall Cobb tonight, and it has been really all season long. Former quarterback who Aaron says really understands what I'm thinking at the quarterback position.
Cobb, five catches for 126 yards. Had the big 70-yarder in the first half. Play clock at two. Lacy, big hole left side. First down. Still going. Tough to bring down. Lacy. Eighth carry of the night. He has 38 yards. That's good for 20.
I think one of the most underrated players in all of football right there, Josh Sitton. The guard just so consistent week in and week out. Pass blocking, run blocking, and he set that edge beautifully that time for Lacy, who did the rest.
There he is, Josh Sitton, fourth round pick in 08 out of Central Florida. Lacy. Tough running again. Sitton and Bakhtiari providing the convoy.
You know, this time I'm just going to give it all to Eddie Lacy, just patiently waiting. And then just getting in behind Josh Sitton. I'm not feeling quite so badly about what he did to Notre Dame that night now. I mean, he's doing it to everybody. He used to study Barry Sanders. He said, back when I was a small man, and then all of a sudden I grew into this. Still has those moves, though.
Said he watched them on YouTube. He didn't watch any football when he was growing up.
Grew up here and really didn't even ever watch the Saints.
Second and three. Rodgers directing traffic. Looking for the first down and gets it as he steps out of bounds, setting up a first down and goal. And Rodgers looked like he was reaching for the back of his leg as he came up at the end of that play.
They came up and flashed a blitz with everybody up the middle, and I tell you, Aaron is shaking something off. Yeah. This is, And when you saw his reaction after picking up the first down, you knew something was up. I'm telling you, that is not a good sign for the Green Bay Packers.
Rubbing his left hamstring as he first and goal here is at the 7-yard line. And
he's hurt.
Yeah, he is. And here's Lacy. And he just had to be a running play to give him a little bit of time, if nothing else. And again, at the end of the play, as he was running out of bounds is when it happened.
Well, so many times you're used to being in Green Bay and a little cooler temperature, you get in the dome and you hope for a cramp if you're a Green Bay Packers, but he is an athlete and he knows he could barely move going back. And you say, well, just put him in shotgun and who cares, but this is a guy whose game is really dependent on that mobility.
Right now they do put him in shotgun on a second and goal. Drifting back in traffic and then just throws it out of the back of the end zone. Everybody covered. It'll be third down and goal.
Ian Lewis, we talked about it, jumped to the outside and took away that little fade route. On the other side, Randall Cobb sitting there, but you could just tell. I mean, that ordinarily was a play that Aaron Rodgers would step up and through and find Devontae Adams in the back of that end zone. He just was not comfortable making that bold first step.
Third and goal from the five. And on a slant, that's in. That's going to be intercepted. Hawthorn comes up with it and takes it out to the 13-yard line. So broken up by White, deflected on a pass intended for Corliss, and a big turnover. David Hawthorn with the interception halfway through the third quarter. Still tied at 16. Not since opening night when Byron Maxwell did it for the Seahawks in Seattle has Rodgers had a pass picked off 2-13 straight. He got no medical attention on the bench, but you see him bending over as Breeze goes to work. The other way now. And this is Ingram taking off for another big run. Mark Ingram having a big, big night as we go back to the interception.
Well, nobody's been under siege more than Corey White, the corner. And what a play he makes on Corliss here. Gets his hand in there. David Hawthorne comes up and makes the interception. So absolutely nothing wrong with the throw. We don't want to make this out to be a bad throw, but a significant development. There's no other way to say it. When you have a quarterback with the mobility, and that's such a big part of his game, a legitimate hamstring issue would be a major factor this season.
Facial expression said it all. That's a first down here on a gain of 12 to Jimmy Graham. So Graham, no catches in the opening half, now has three here in the second half.
But you're starting to see Jimmy Graham look like Jimmy Graham again. And I think sometimes when you have a shoulder ailment, you have to get hit and land on the ground and get up a few times before you start feeling good about that. You see Drew Brees craning his neck, and never too hard to find the big guy, Jimmy Graham.
Ready, under.
Out to the 41-yard line.
You're killed.
Ingram, meanwhile, 94 yards on 13 carries tonight. Brees fires over the middle, and he goes to the big man again. So four catches to Graham. This one good for 9 yards, second and one.
I'm just telling you, the clock is ticking right now on a deep ball. Because now you've got the single high safety. Jimmy Graham's taken over in the middle of the field. And eventually he's going to cut loose one of these fly guys on the outside. Kenny Stills has made a lot of big plays. Brandon Cooks, a lot of speed. And just about the time you start paying attention to Jimmy Graham inside, you get the deep shot.
For the moment, Graham's out. They go in with double tight ends in Watson and Hill. And Bree stepping up. There goes your deep ball. Brandon Cooks. Your clock was ticking and it just struck midnight. 50 yards.
Just split in between the two defensive backs on that side. Micah Hyde, I don't think, has seen anybody that can run like Brandon Cooks. And the big play ability of this offense with Drew Brees is a frightening thing. He still has the underneath guys with Marcus Colston. He was working Jimmy Graham. And you could just tell. I could see those defensive backs starting to creep up. And you knew sooner or later they were going to get drilled.
On a second and one with Graham out of the game, to the rookie they go. His fifth catch of the night, 91 yards. Graham for the extra point. And that one is just good, just inside the right upright. With 5.5 minutes to play in the third quarter, following the interception, they go 88 yards and four plays and lead 23-16. Jimmy Fallon in New York this week on The Tonight Show. Guests will include, there's Mike Tyson. He'll be along, so will Kevin Spacey. Jimmy Fallon and The Tonight Show all this week on NBC. As you look down upon the Mercedes-Benz Superdome right next door in New Orleans Arena, where the New Orleans Pelicans of the NBA will open up their season this week. Saints have the lead by 7. And Aaron Rodgers, and we'll keep an eye on that leg when he comes back out to take over at the 20. Sunday Night Football in New Orleans being brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes can save you 15% on car insurance. By McDonald's, official sponsor of the NFL. I'm loving it. By Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing. And by U.S. Bank, all of us serving you, member FDIC. All right, Aaron Rodgers now from the 20-yard line. Starts from the shotgun. His team down by 7. Gets it to the outside and behind Cobb. And Michelle, what do you know about Rodgers?
Well, we saw him come to the sideline grabbing that left leg. He sat on the bench and talked with Dr. Pat McKenzie, the team physician, for a little while. Other than that, no treatment, but he's been stretching it and, you know, kind of pressing on it. We're going to see now if he can be as light on his feet and have the same burst. If it's a hamstring, he may not have that out.
Yeah, we'll keep a very close eye on him, Michelle. He lines up again in the gun on second down and 10. Their backup quarterback will be Matt Flynn. across to Lacy. Cuts it back.
Wow.
Look at him. Turns a four-yard gain and what would have been a third and six into a first down.
I mean, this is really just all Eddie Lacy, and this looked like it's going to be a gain of nothing. Cuts back into everything. Two clean shots from NFL players, and he ends up picking up the first down. Now back under center. The running game's been so good, you don't want to leave him in shotgun.
And Lacy trying to find a little bit of open space. Gain of a couple. Under 5 minutes to play now. Third quarter.
You know, a lot of teams do this when they have the offense on their side of the 50. They start bringing in some backup defensive linemen so that their guys can get a little bit of a break. There's John Jenkins in there, Tyron Walker in there, Brandon Dedrick, I believe, has been in there.
Second and seven. It's off the hands of Richard Rodgers, the tight end, setting up third and seven.
You know, Al, this is a kind of an interesting moment here, and you wonder if Rob Ryan knows that Aaron Rodgers is hurting here. Now, the zone's been working great. There's no reason for him to change out of this, but if you were going to rush him and you were going to blitz him, you may want to test that hamstring as they're backed up on your side of the 50.
And there's the backup, Matt Flynn, staying loose. Starks is the running back. And again, they only sent four, and the pass is caught. Devontae Adams, and the official comes in to spot it, and that's going to be a first down.
That was an interesting mark.
Ooh, yes.
A difficult mark. You see him come up and out here. He came back to the ball, and I think that where the forward progress stopped, they can challenge that.
Yeah, you can challenge it. I mean, now Peyton can say, let's go take a look at that again.
The game was stopped for an injured player.
All right. It wasn't stopped for a challenge.
Yeah, I don't think they would win the challenge, though, to be honest with you.
Me neither.
I think that the ball was caught and his momentum was going backwards. Oh, well, here we go.
Well, I still think he's – I don't – well, who knows? Nobody knows anything. What are we talking about? There's the challenge flag. So where is forward progress stopped? So it'll either be a first down or it will be a fourth down.
The challenging ruling on the field that it was a first down.
And so Ed Hockley will go under the hood. Get the result, we'll come back. Ed Hockley with the call here on the challenge.
The receiver caught the ball beyond the stake, but he, on his own power, before he was touched down, came back and was touched down short of the line to gain. Therefore, the ball is on the 40-and-a-half yard line. It is fourth down on the 40-and-a-half. There are no charge timeouts.
So it's fourth down, fourth and inches. Take a look again. He goes back under his own power, and when is he first touched? The feet make contact, so he's
right there
is where the ball is, and it's a little bit short of the first down.
Yeah, but you can't see the ball
right.
You can't. Now you can put them together
right here. You can
right there.
Yep.
And that's pretty close to that line right there.
Yep.
The official sticks were on the other side, so they actually are going to measure that. You wonder, because we didn't see him kick the foot with the first look either.
Right.
And you wonder if they in fact saw the foot contact or just the when he hit him up high.
Right. See, he's considerably short of the first down there. Half a yard. Go back again. Here's where the play should be dead. Right
there.
There. When the feet touch. If you don't see that on replay, then
there,
you wait for him to be hit.
There's the tip. Is it short? I can't draw that straight of a line.
No.
And those aren't the official sticks anyway. Ed Hockley, one of the top officials in the game, no question about it. You trust his judgment. They see it in New York as well. So you live with it.
So down by seven. Breeze ready to come back in, and we'll see if he comes back in on the next play or It's a first down. Eddie Lacy is the running back. They bring Kuhn in as the fullback. And they give it to Lacy, and he is going to be stopped short. Green Bay thinks he has it. Of course, the Saints think otherwise, and Hockey League agrees with the Saints. So the Saints earlier came up short on the fourth down play. The Packers do here, and Breeze will have the ball at the Green Bay 40. Well, you're looking at the confluence of the Three Rivers in Pittsburgh, and we will be there next Sunday. The Ravens against the Steelers, one of the great rivalries over the past several years. Football Night starts at 7 Eastern Time. Ben Roethlisberger, 522 through the air and 6 touchdowns. Cincinnati winning today, beating Baltimore, and that's about as tight as it can get. Cleveland in the race. Browns beat Oakland today, they're 4-3. Now Breeze from the 40. After taking over on downs, and the catch is made, again of about 4 for Eric Long, the fullback. Eric Loring.
How much has this game changed since Aaron Rodgers went out of bounds and grabbed the back of his leg? Immediately the interception, come back and turn the ball back over on downs.
One would tell anybody is Ingram makes it a 3rd-and-1 that he missed half the year last year with a broken collarbone. The only good news is whatever it is, they have a bye week that couldn't come at a better time right now for Green Bay, and don't play again until 2 weeks from tonight on Sunday Night Football at Lambeau against the Bears.
I'll tell you what couldn't come at a better time is the way Mark Ingram's playing tonight. He has been a load.
99 yards for Ingram and a half on 14 attempts. Into triple figures. Donald Armstead around the left side. First down.
Talked about the speed. The fastest offensive lineman at the combine, Teron Armstead. And we were talking with Sean Payton, the head coach, a little bit about him. And he said that basically what Armstead allows us to do is to get those reach blocks. They've been very effective running to the outside because he is so athletic. So they crack down with some of the receivers, get him running in front, and they've been very effective running outside the tackles.
A little over 2 minutes to go in the third. Good, clean pocket. Deep throw, catch made, touchdown. Tremont Williams with the coverage, and Jimmy Graham, who looked like anything but himself over the last game and a half, last couple of weeks, in fact, 5 catches in this half.
Man coverage against their best cover corner, and Jimmy Graham, welcome back. Had it all the way, and you could just tell the confidence growing as he made those catches, was getting tackled. He looked great in practice this week. Drew Brees felt confident. And look out, if Jimmy Graham is back, the Saints are back.
8-inch advantage over Williams. And the extra point is good. 30-16. Well, you take a look, and we talk about it every time we have the New Orleans Saints. We've talked about how great they are in the Superdome. They're almost victims of their own success. We're talking to Sean Payton the other day about it. He goes, you know, we're pretty good on the road too, but compared to the way they are at home, there's a tremendous difference.
Yeah, and there is you never want to play them right before Halloween either, because you get the party atmosphere going in here. But there is something about this team. We have seen a really top-notch opponents just get avalanched. And the Green Bay Packers look like they were borderline unstoppable here early. And all of a sudden now, the defense has been playing well, and Jimmy Graham is hot, and look out.
10-game home winning streak in the regular season. They ran the table last year here. 7-game road losing streak. But in postseason last year, they did go into Philadelphia and beat the Eagles. And, of course, they had to go to Seattle, and they lost there to the Seahawks.
There are some guys on offense you just can't lose. Not to lose them, but Jimmy Graham is one of those guys that everything else revolves around it. They went and got the speed on the outside, but without that impact of Graham inside, this offense hasn't been the same.
And then Morris did with another touchback. Rodgers had that tremendous first quarter, 203 yards. Since then, 8 of 15, one pick. And on this run around the right side, picked up the first down, but at the end of the play, you can see him reaching for that hamstring. And you knew right there, and you could tell by his facial expression, he knew something. The hamstring got tweaked.
And it's not even the running, Al, that concerns me. It's that ability inside the pocket to just maneuver around, buy time.
It's having confidence in it, too.
Yeah.
Knowing it's there, the ball's at the 20, go to the outside, that's caught, and then wrapped up and taken down as Devontae Adams after a gain of six. Tackled there by Corey White.
Well, they have been all over these short routes tonight, in part because they've had two deep safeties on almost every snap. So the corners now have confidence to get up and play these guys hard because they know if they get beat at the line of scrimmage, there's somebody behind them.
And second and four, that is caught. Adams again, that's a first down as he gets it out to the 38-yard line. The rookie second-round pick out of Fresno State.
Well, you get the feeling this Devontae Adams is going to be a good one, don't you? 131 catches, 24 touchdowns at Fresno State. Just remarkable to look at his numbers. And if he can become that trusted number three with Eddie Lacy in the backfield, wow.
And it's Lacy reaching behind him. Nice catch and a good run to the 50-yard line he goes. And that is a first down. Final minute of the third quarter.
Just you see him look back and just like he's throwing it at a dartboard or something. Flick that thing out there. For Aaron Rodgers, when you're injured as an athlete, sometimes you just have to say, I don't care. I just have to go play my game.
He's thrown for 334 yards. And again, clean pocket, juggling catch. That's made by Andrew Corliss, the tight end. Final half minute now of the period.
He's disappointed himself, Aaron Rodgers was, because he didn't get that ball out in front of Corliss. But I think for Aaron Rodgers, just knowing that he can still play, you know, when you pull your hamstring, you're not sure what the rest of the game's going to be like, so maybe he's gaining some confidence like Jimmy Graham.
Second and three, fakes the inside, he throws first down. That is Jordy Nelson, and that takes us to the end of the third quarter. We go on to the fourth in the Superdome. It's 30-16 Saints, and Sunday Night Football resumes after these messages. Tonight's aerial coverage being brought to you by Geico, along with our producer Fred Godelli, director Drew Esikoff, manning the controls, Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, and Michelle Tafoya. New Orleans on a beautiful Sunday night, final Sunday night of October. 30-16 Saints. First and 10. Rodgers out of the gun from the 36-yard line. Gets sacked. Cameron Jordan.
Well, welcome back to the Pro Bowler, Cameron Jordan. 12 and a half sacks a year ago, and not a lot of productivity so far this year, but he has had a major impact on this game. That is second.
Here tonight. Three on the year, second and 15. And Rodgers forced out, intercepted at the 30-yard line. Corey White off the deflection, off the hands of Devontae Adams. So Aaron Rodgers picked off once in 7.5 games, picked off twice tonight. Sunday Night Football being brought to you by Verizon XLTE and America's largest, most reliable 4G LTE network. By National Car Rental, go national, go like a pro. By Navy Federal Credit Union, serving the armed forces and their families. And by Kia Motors, visit Kia.com to learn more. Mardi Gras World here in New Orleans, where the floats for over 40 annual parades are built, put on display, including one of Drew Brees. From the 29 after the interception, Ingram, about 15 yards, and Ingram with 126 yards thrown.
Go back to the interception, Devontae Adams. You'll see man coverage, everybody chasing a man. Devontae Adams, you do not stop on man coverage. You keep coming, he slowed down, and it was Aaron Rodgers anticipating the young rookie receiver was going to keep coming across there, totally on Devontae Adams. He misread the coverage.
Ready. Yellow 80, yellow 80. Ready. You ready, my son?
On the ground again, and this time it's Cadet. Tavares Cadet, third-year guy from Appalachian State. Giving Ingram a breather.
I'll tell you, this Saints offensive line tonight has done a job. Ben Grubbs, Jari Evans, Pro Bowlers, Tron Armstead, we've talked about him, Zach Streif, but Tim Lolito right inside at the center position, taking over for Jonathan Goodwin, is an excellent run blocker, and the uptick may very well be due to him.
Now Breeze looking for the kill shot, and the pass is incomplete. There's a flag coming in, and you can tell by McCarthy's reaction who it's going to be against. Illegal contact.
Pass interference, defense number 31. It was a cutoff. The ball is placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
Pass interference, but at the spot of the foul, which is going to be all the way down to about the 11-yard line.
Does cut him off, but I mean, you have to let defenders play a little bit, don't you? And the ball was wow
34 yard penalty.
Oh wow.
Yep. Okie Mike 50, Omaha, Rimmel.
Three tight ends, there's an Omaha, and the pass at the 13 yard line is caught by Cooks.
A lot of times on those plays, it is just strictly Drew Brees' decision. I think that was strictly a running play. And if Drew Brees likes it, he can just raise up and take the quick slant. Why not? Just as easy to throw for 4 yards.
Second down and seven.
Mike, seven.
At the 13.
You ready, my son?
Through the middle. Taking the Packers with him. Ingram. Close to it. But then the Packers think the ball came out. But Hockley's right there to say,
Watch Jimmy Graham come across here. You can tell he's still hurting. He does not want to drop that shoulder in there. He's doing the best he can. He knew how important this game was. But Clay Matthews, you wanted no part of him. Drew Brees wants the next play to be run.
Right, because there was a question as to with McCarthy, and now he's going to try to get word from upstairs because Green Bay thought they had recovered a fumble, but in effect, and he's just checking this out right now. Take a look. Was the play whistle dead? Forward progress appears to have been stopped.
Question.
No. Yep. But anyway, you know, there McCarthy figures really there's not a lot to lose here. Maybe he gets the benefit of the doubt.
Timeout New Orleans. That's their first.
Well, the Saints are going to take a timeout. All right. A lot going on. We'll be back. We're back after a play in which the ball carrier gets basically swallowed up inside Ingram. Ball came out, but forward progress had been ruled. Forward progress had been stopped, and there goes Hyde. I'll tell you what, though, that's pretty close because he ripped it out and came away with the ball. There is no challenge. Instead, a third and one here, and then the pass is caught out in the flat by Austin Johnson, and that will be a first down.
A really nice job by Austin Johnson there. He caught the ball well short of the first down, but in true fullback fashion, and he's got a little pitch in his giddy up there, but he got immediately up the field where he catches this ball. He's still a yard or two short, drops that shoulder and carries Lattimore down for the first down.
First and goal at the 5. Under 11 to play in the 4th. Play clock 1. And there's a delay of game. Breeze is trying to get a timeout.
Delay of game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. The first down.
Yeah, Sean Payton was trying to get it first. He just could not get it called in time.
Well, he had just taken one, so two remain. First and goal now from the 10-yard line. On the ground once again, taking the ball to the 2 goes Mark Ingram. Looking every bit like a one-time Heisman Trophy winner tonight, 136 yards, 18 carries.
And Grubbs going to come around here and lead the way, but this is just great run blocking. It really is. I mean, Tim Lolito, Jari Evans, Ben Grubbs, they have been dynamic inside. Zach Strieff, Ron Armstead on the edge. They have won the battle. That has been the one question mark about Green Bay. Could they stop the run?
Second and goal, play action, little floater. Wide open, Josh Hill, touchdown.
You can't stop the run. You have to commit to it. And when you do that, you leave yourself vulnerable to the bootleg.
Backup tight end. He's caught 9 passes this year, 3 of them in the end zone.
I don't think I can remember a game turning so quickly after an injury that nobody had to leave the field for.
Right. And a couple of calls that will be lamented by every Packer fan tonight. But every NFL team has calls to be lamented. What else is good? 37-16 New Orleans. With NFL Mobile, you can stream live local Sunday afternoon and primetime games right on your mobile device. Learn more at NFL.com/mobile.
Man's got the snake there. Just don't know what to do.
21-point lead as Green Bay will start from the 20-yard line. So at one point, we were tied at 16, and now 37-16 in New Orleans. Breeders' Cup weekend coming up. Beautiful Santa Anita Park, Arcadia, California, California Chrome. Derby winner, he'll be in action in the Breeders' Cup Classic. Coverage will start on Friday on NBCSN, leading up to the Classic in prime time Saturday on NBC. Now Rodgers dancing around under pressure, going to get sacked at the 16-yard line by Kasim Edebali.
Little adjustment on the coverage now, still with the two deep safeties, but this is called two-man, so the corners basically run underneath. The wide receivers, again, don't care if they go deep because they have the two safeties in behind them. So just a little adjustment here by Rob Ryan, who has just called a masterful game tonight.
3 sacks, 2nd and 14. Pass caught, Nelson. And he'll get slugged out of bounds at the 26-yard line. They've really done a great job on him. But really, you go back to the Rodgers run and then reaching for his left hamstring. And he's been rubbing it from time to time. A few plays later, he's got the interception here. Another interception later, and a tie game has turned into a three-touchdown lead against him. 35. Too high. Flag is thrown.
It's like a little illegal contact, maybe.
Yep.
And Corey White. There's definitely some bumping down the field. Of course, there with his hands behind his back like a schoolboy in trouble.
Might have two fouls. There's a penalty flag back at
the
17.
There were two fouls on the defense on the play. Illegal contact. Number 24, that penalty is declined. It was also a personal foul, roughing the passer, contact with the hand of the quarterback's head. That's a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Baron Walker is the guy who comes in and hits Rodgers where you can.
Yep, trying to deflect the pass or hit his arm or whatever, but it comes down on the helmet of the quarterback, and they don't care how hard it is either. So a little break here. You know, a lot of teams, you go, like, this game's over. Aaron Rodgers playing, nothing's over.
One thing you really love to do is get Jordy Nelson more involved in the game. They've done a great job, Ryan's group has, on Nelson. Three catches, 25 yards. Came in second in the league in receiving yardage. He's been very limited tonight. Flag thrown again. Low pass taken off the ground by Richard Rodgers, and Aaron Rodgers gets taken to the turf again by Walker.
And Rodgers is limping, and Tyron Walker drilled him.
Illegal hands to the face, offense number 71. 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Josh Shitton.
What's a shot here by Tyron Walker. Legal hit there, and Josh Sitton with the illegal hands to the face. That's kind of a new rule this year, or new emphasis, or whatever they call it, where they you can't just go quickly to the face mask and get it back down. They're calling even that now.
Whatever they call it, perfect description. First and 20. And that's caught for a big game, and the flag is thrown again. That's Richard Rodgers. And now this one will be against the Saints, and that's going to turn it into an automatic first down. Funny thing, an automatic first down is going to cost them some yardage.
Holding defense, number 28. That's a 5-yard penalty from the previous spot where the ball was snapped, and an automatic first down.
It's interesting, had they declined the penalty,
that would have been second.
Green Bay has elected to decline the penalty.
Yeah, you see, that's what I was thinking.
Down.
Be second
right,
short.
Right, they had a first and 20, so it's one of those things where you want the automatic first down, but it costs you a bunch of yardage, or take or decline it. And have it was a 17-yard game, making it a second down and 3.
Maybe Aaron Rodgers just wanted the yardage. I had a quarterback once said he declined one like that just so he could pick up the yardage. Don't mention jump, his name. Jump, no. Had to go back a little bit more.
All right. Greg Cook, Virgil Carter. Second down and 3 with the ball at the 47-yard line. Caught, first down. Adams makes the catch, gets spun down at the 41-yard line. Clock down under 8 minutes.
You know, the good news is that they're doing a good job now on Randall Cobb and Jordy Nelson, but they're creating opportunities for Devontae Adams. See if he can take advantage.
And over the middle, Mason to the 34-yard line. So good-looking drive here. 7.5 minutes to play. Rodgers, 393 yards tonight.
You know, the problem hasn't been moving the ball for the Packers. It's been scoring once they got to the red zone.
from the dump again to Lacey. And Lacey to the 30-yard line, gain of about three. Lacey's in triple figures in receiving yardage tonight. Of course, most of that was on that 67-yard catch and run in the first quarter.
Blues had a great night, but you go back, what do they have? In the red zone, two field goals and one interception so far for the Green Bay Packers, and they came in ranked number three in the NFL in efficiency in that red zone.
Third and one.
Offside offense, number 17. 5-yard penalty, it's third down.
That's Devontae Adams.
You get the good and the bad when you get the rookies.
Yes, you do.
Here we go, right here.
And you don't often see a false start with 20 seconds on the play clock.
20 seconds on the play clock and the crowd going crazy. I don't even know how you heard the snap count.
Makes it a third down and six. And behind Lacey, fourth down, and Akeem Hicks came in and puts Rodgers on the ground. So it's fourth down.
Well, again, we've seen it. This is the coverage of choice now. They're playing two-man, man underneath. And ordinarily, to the guys on the other side, same sort of deal. Ordinarily, Aaron Rodgers against that coverage would run the football because it is the perfect. Everybody has their back turned and running away from you. But you just wonder if he's comfortable trying to take off right now.
Last chance saloon right here for Green Bay, fourth and six. Rodgers sliding, gets away, throws along the far sideline, caught for a first down. Lacey, before he goes out of bounds, able to keep their hopes slightly alive, moving the chains.
Well, good news here. Aaron Rodgers looking like Aaron Rodgers of old, just buying some time. And for Eddie Lacey, huge play in the game. Remember, this is a guy they took out of the game on third down last year. Good job dragging the toes. Beautifully done.
From the 26. Underneath again, Lacey. Lacey to the 19-yard line. So throwing to Lacey a lot tonight. He's caught eight for 123 yards, and he's run for 59.
This is a dog-tired pass rush, and Aaron Rodgers is not letting them substitute.
Second and three. And that'll be a first down. Richard Rodgers, the 6'4", 260-pound rookie tight end.
So now the Packers substitute, but the Saints opt not to. So they would have had the opportunity to sub if they wanted to. And you can see the guys' hands on their hips trying to catch their breath. I thought they might have taken advantage of that.
Four guys in four-point stances here. And Aaron's going to take off. First down and a touchdown. So it opens up in the middle, but he's still a little gimpy as he crosses the goal line. 14-yard run.
Well, they never changed the coverage. They played two-man all the way down. So when you're playing this coverage, you get man coverage on all these guys, and all the people on the outside are playing man. They turn and run away from the quarterback. So probably about 75% of the time, you see quarterbacks break that defense just running the ball. But, Aaron, that was about all he had, but it was good enough.
Yep. So the game not over, but a certain threshold is over, as the extra point is good by Mason Crosby. Back to a two-touchdown game. 37-23, Saints, 5:07 to go. So the Packers are going to kick off, and the question is, does McCarthy want to try an onside kick? Not that the Saints wouldn't expect it, because they have almost everybody up at the 45-yard line.
The two guys in the position to make the catch, Marcus Colston coming this way and Jimmy Graham the other way.
And they will try it. And the ball is loose.
It never got close to 10 yards, but they touched it.
See who's at the bottom of the pile here. Micah Hyde is right there for the Packers. Of course, each team signaling they have it, but it's going to wind up in the hands of the Saints. Benjamin Watson The tight end is the guy who comes up with the ball for the Saints.
All the guys on that front line basically going up the block. The ball never got close to going 10 yards. A little trickery there. But once the ball is touched, you can see the guys coming up and trying to block. And it looked like Lorig maybe was the first one to touch it. So big break for the Saints. They were able to jump on it because it was a live ball at that point.
And Graham is there too. You got, see, it hits the back of Lorig. And then it's anybody's football, and it turns out to be the Saints. So now they have it at the 32-yard line. They can go to work on the clock. And what better way to do it than with Mark Ingram for a gain of three.
We talked about the speed merchant on the outside. Brandon Cooks, first ball with the jet sweep. Nobody's even saw that one coming. Blazed in. Tipped one to himself for a big play. And then this is the one where 40-yard dash time does make a difference on this one. This run right by the two defenders of the Packers, and that really was the big play of the night. Good young receivers here. Kenny Stills, like him, Brandon Cooks. They're in transition. You know, sometimes transition happens subtly, but they are clearly an offense and a defense in transition.
Green Bay just took a timeout trying to conserve whatever they can at this point. Have two remaining, second down and seven. And Ingram is going to take the ball inside the 25 to the 24-yard line. So clearly already in field goal range, which would make it a three-possession game. There goes Hawthorne, who had an interception earlier, going to the locker room. And upcoming will be a third down and two.
I think Mark Ingram is going to start paying us to come, Al. Remember the last time he was over 100 yards on Sunday Night Football against the Cowboys? About 145 yards rushing that night and 144 so far this evening. If I had to pick out a star of the game right now, maybe the offensive line first, but Mark Ingram kind of has been my guy.
Well, not when they really needed him with the two other backs hurt. And this time, he thrusts forward and picks up the first down.
What a great jump cut here. He basically gets the two Packers to almost knock themselves out. He's going to jump and split up and then watch the two defenders come up and hit each other. He has been making people miss like that all night. Tremont Williams and Sam Barrington about knock each other out on the play. Nobody has been able to corral Mark Ingram.
Had the broken hand early, missed three games, carried 10 times last week in Detroit. And tonight he's been the stud. And this time he gets wrapped up before he can reach the line of scrimmage. NFC North standings. And Green Bay was done no favor today by the Atlanta Falcons with a 21-0 lead at Wembley Stadium. And then Detroit wins the game 22-21 with a crazy ending. After it looked like it was a missed field goal, but with 1 second left on the clock, he was able to bang it through. Prater was able to hit it to give Detroit the win over Atlanta. Green Bay 5-2 at the moment, but on the precipice of going to 5-3.
I don't know about you, but I like that morning football. I felt like I was watching on the West Coast, right? You wake up and football's on and it's on all day. I thought that was great. I hope we get more of that.
Football is never off.
No, let's keep that rolling. Get a team in London and wake up at least eight times a year and watch a little morning football.
We live long enough for them Wednesday pre-dawn football. Ingram, all the way, touchdown.
This little three tight end package, now that Jimmy Graham is healthy on the edge, has been dynamic. And Devon House, just go ahead and add your name to the list. Nobody seems to be able to tackle Mark Ingram tonight. What a night he has had. As good as I have ever seen him play.
Excess of riches in that offensive backfield running backs with Kyrie Robinson, with Pierre Thomas. So with those guys down tonight, it's Ingram. Huge night for him, 168 yards and a touchdown, 23 carries, 3:16 to go. And the Saints are on top, 44-23.
Josh Hill, Jimmy Graham just wiped him right down, Nick Perry, and then it was all Mark Ingram, a little stiff arm to the face of Devon House. What a night.
Curious to see if McCarthy's going to let Rodgers finish this game.
I'm going to guess not.
I would think not, because he's gimpy. We saw what happened. We've documented it since it happened, and Matt Flynn would be the backup quarterback. And the good news for Green Bay is they have a bye week.
You know what's really interesting is that Sean Payton told us the other day he felt like he had a better handle on what the Green Bay Packers do defensively than he ever had going into a game. He thought he had some real tips on some of their tendencies, and I would say this is one of the better games he has called in a big situation. His team desperately needed to get back on track, and Sean Payton tonight has been masterful.
So when this is over and done with, they will be 3-0 under the dome and 0-4 in foreign territory. And the good news, as we said at the top, is counting this game tonight, 4 of 5 at home, 400 yards or more passing today. Roethlisberger at 522. Rodgers done for the night, 418. Foles in a losing cause at Arizona, 411. And Luck in a losing cause against Roethlisberger, 400 yards. First day in the history of the league for players with 400 or more. Matt Flynn's going to come in and finish this up so that they don't endanger Rodgers and that hamstring, or we assume it's the hamstring anymore. Flynn earned a big contract with Seattle when he got to play the final game of the season in 2011 against Detroit. Then he goes to Seattle. They pay him a lot of money, and then Russell Wilson gets drafted in the third round and wins the job by opening day. Pass to Adams is good, and then Flynn leaves there, goes to Oakland. That didn't work out either, and comes back now to provide some insurance.
Now there's 23 points up there, but this New Orleans Saints defense, off of their best performance in Detroit, came right back. Relatively conservative, not many blitzes. Got it done when it mattered.
And Flynn, before the arm comes forward, it is ruled a fumble. Edebali comes in, and New Orleans has the ball. Edebali, a rookie out of Boston College, second sack, and that time creates the turnover.
Edebali doing his best junior to look how low the ground he is. He's coming out of there like Usain Bolt or something. Comes around, and that does count as a sack and a fumble and the whole thing, and he is excited.
That's not the NASCAR package. That's got to be like that's the Grand Prix of Monaco package.
Indy cars.
Yeah.
Down hugging the ground.
Get down low.
That man grew up in Hamburg, Germany.
Ball to 23. Ingram's going to add to his stats here. And that play took enough so that they don't have to run another play before the two-minute warning. Meanwhile, you got two guys in the game, the two punters, haven't seen any action. Mastay and Morstead. Morstead's actually seen action as the kickoff man. Bunch of touchbacks tonight. But regular season games without a punt. You saw the graphic there.
You know, the interesting part of this whole night to me was that the Green Bay Packers defense came in number one in the NFL in opposing quarterback rating, just 74, which is really low. And tonight, 137, 140, whatever it's been for Drew Brees, he has not been stopped.
A pair of minutes left in New Orleans, 44-23 Saints. Volkswagen post-game report following, and Michelle will be down in the field with the stars of the game. Bob, Tony, and Mike break it down, look ahead to other things happening around the league, and we'll take a look ahead to next week's matchup in Pittsburgh between the Steelers and the Baltimore Ravens. So in Green Bay, the big question will be Aaron Rodgers, the extent of his, what we assume is a hamstring tweak, pull, whatever you want to call it, and the fact they'll have a bye week, and we will see them on Sunday Night Football the next time they play in a fortnight against the Chicago Bears. Second and six. And Eric Lurie. And Chris, this is what you were talking about. Going into the break, that Packer defense. And you mentioned that Dom Capers, I'd never heard this said before, the difference between the passer rating, what you guys do offensively, the other guys do defensively. And then you can look at numbers a lot of different ways, and that's Dom's preferential statistic.
Well, they haven't seen Drew Brees yet either. The list of quarterbacks they face at this point pales in comparison to this guy.
Third and a deuce. Fumble. Lorig loses the football, and the Packers are going to wind up with it in the minute 11. Tremont Williams comes away with it. Brees, first player in the history of the league with 300 or more yards in six straight games against one opponent. So there is numbers against the Packers. That first game in 03, he was a San Diego Charger. All of the rest, of course, as a Saint, joined this club in 2006. So he owns Dairyland.
it was interesting talking to him this week, too, and he said, there's a lot of things we've got to get cleaned up around here, and not necessarily football-related. He was looking for leaders, especially on the defensive side. He said, we lost Will Smith, Jabari Greer, Roman Harper, Malcolm Jenkins, Jonathan Vilma, and it's a big deal, and we haven't replaced them yet with leaders on the defensive side. So Rob Bryan, I think, has gone back to basics a little bit. It goes against his DNA to not blitz. But 2 weeks in a row now, maybe simplifying things has really helped this defense.
Here's DeJuan Harris, the backup running back, taking down. The other guy, of course, they lost on offense was Sproles. And Saints lost a lot of guys to free agency during the offseason, trades, what have you, and didn't pick up very much. But seemed to have righted the ship, at least in the friendly confines of the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. There they were. Some big names.
Now, if you're a Saints fan, it's hard to believe that you're going to be playing for first place in your division next week with four losses, but that's the way it goes on Thursday night.
They go to Charlotte. So another home win. Another win by 21 points. 12 straight primetime wins in the regular season, also two in the playoffs, and almost every one of them has been, at the end of the day or night, a rout. He was tied at the half at 16, the second half belonging to the Saints. Check on Rodgers, of course, over the next week or two, heading into their game against Chicago, and we will head to the Volkswagen post-game report after these messages.